Max, should Seattle consider moving him?
You have to consider, in the NFL, anyone is movable. You always have to consider it. But would I trade Richard Sherman if I were Seattle? No. When Earl Thomas is back there, that combination, I mean, where do you find corners of Sherman's quality? They're not growing on trees. That's a rare and excellent and exceptionally important commodity in today's NFL, the way offenses work, the defensive backfield so important. Sherman is elite, particularly when Earl Thomas is also back there. I wouldn't move him.
Go ahead, Will.
I would definitely consider it. I mean, if the going rate for a marquee corner in the NFL is a first-round draft pick, if that's what we're seeing from Malcolm Butler, you have to consider it with Richard Sherman, age 29 or turns 29 in a few days. We talked about Darrell Revis many times over the last few days. And it, when Darrell Revis was 29, he was the third-ranked corner, according to Pro Football Focus, in the NFL. He quickly went down at age 30 and 31 to this past year being the 66th-ranked corner. I'm not saying that Richard Sherman is Darrell Revis. Well, Max, I mean, there's an example of the cliff.
There's certain ages where certain positions fall off.
In retrospect. But I would suggest if there's value to be gained from a man who is turning 29 and currently at the peak of his game, you might think about the corner's peak at age 23, 24, 25 and see if you can find the next Richard Sherman.
Well, listen, if you're talking about just numbers and age and all of that stuff, I'm not here to refute that. I thought we were talking about a brother's game here. And if we're talking about his game, I don't want to hear this nonsense about trading Richard Sherman. Who the hell are you going to have to replace him if you're the Seattle Seahawks? Yes, he's going to turn 28. Oh, my God. Let's wipe the dust off of that birth certificate. He's going to turn 29 soon. Are you kidding me? He's one of the top corners in the game. And by the way, who's on the opposite ends of the corner? What? Sean Sheed and Jeremy Lane. That's what y'all got for me? And we having a conversation about trading Richard Sherman from the number three ranked defense in the National Football
There's
League?
No debate.
What the hell
There's
have
no
you
debate
two
about who
been
Richard
drinking Sher- this morning? Max, your ice cold, what is that, iced tea or whatever, iced coffee that you've been drinking? Will, what the hell are you drinking in the morning? We're having a discussion for the number three defense in the NFL. The Legion of Boom with this dude at the cornerback slot where you don't even get to complete half your passes against him. And
Steven,
you got
Sheed and Jeremy Lane
on the other side of the field. He's got his side of the field on lockdown, and we're talking about moving him?
You know what Branch Rickey used to say?
Branch Rickey, who's one of the greatest GMs ever, invented the farm system in baseball.
Stop it with your baseball analogies.
Broke the color barrier with Jackie Robinson.
I'm sick of your
Branch Rickey used to say, trade a player a year too early instead of a year too late, to Will's point. There may be some wisdom in that, which is why I would listen.
Could you quote somebody from the new millennial? Could you at least do that for me? Could you quote somebody from the new millennial? That's 1947. Could you quote somebody from the new millennial? Could you
but
do
Will,
it?
When you even a first round draft pick at the corner position is still, it's not a total crapshoot, but you're hoping, you're projecting. Richard Sherman is still excellent. He's still premium at a premium position right now.
There's no debate about who Richard Sherman has been or who he is right now. You're not suckering me into that debate, Stephen A. It's about who Richard Sherman will be over the next 3 years.
You should be ashamed of yourself, both of you. Both of you should be ashamed of yourself.
All right.
And Max, stop bringing up baseball quotes from the 40s.